Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. Cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity.
Hello, everybody. Cartage back here again. And today I'm going to be doing a little bit of a, well, as usual, it's going to be a haul. So, yeah. And as you can see, I am growing the, as I like to call it, the October growth before No Shave November. And it's going good so far. Pretty soon, this guy will be gone. And then No Shave November will start October 31st after I get rid of all of this and then start from the beginning. And then a whole 30 days of no shaving. But anyway, without any further ado, let's get right into the books, starting off with the Marvel pile. And this is everything I've picked up since I've been at college. So, starting off, this one's a newer one, and this is Immortal Hulk number 38 so far. This one has my favorite, like, story in it so far. And, yeah. Pretty good story. If you have not read The Immortal Hulk, really, really gotta recommend that. Next up, I have Avengers of the Wasteland number 5, and I love this series, along with Old Man Logan and Old Man Hawkeye and Old Man Quill. Like, I just love the whole, like, Old Man Logan universe, as I'm gonna think of it. It's a pretty amazing story. And then next up is issue number 37 of The Immortal Hulk. And again, Immortal Hulk, definitely one of my favorite stories at the moment. And then I have The Immortal She-Hulk. And I basically picked this one up because it's an Immortal Hulk book, technically, as I am going to think of it. And I thought it was a pretty cool looking cover. And then next up, I have Juggernaut issue number 1, and just from the first story, I really do love it. It's a pretty amazing story, and yeah, I can't say a whole lot more about that without spoiling it, so I really, really do recommend you guys go check that out. And another Immortal Hulk book, and that is The Immortal Hulk, The Threshing Place, and this one's actually not written by, what's his name, Al Ewan. This is actually written by someone else, I think that is Lemire, and this is just kind of like a one-off story, and the artwork is just way different in this compared to, like, the normal books, but it was still a good read. I enjoyed it. And sorry about my nose, it's kind of a little stuffy. And then next up I have Doctor Doom issue 7, and I really do love this Doctor Doom series. It's amazing, and I can't wait for issue 8. And then a series I am almost complete with, I just need to wait for issue number 6 to come out, and that is Marvel's X, and this is a fantastic story, in my opinion. Like, so much detail into every, like, panel. Such an amazing story, just spectacular. And then after I read this, I'm gonna find the, I think it was called Earth X, if I'm not mistaken, but that is basically what comes after Marvel's X, so I'm pretty excited for that. And then this one's just kind of a little bit of a random comic that I picked up because I really thought it sounded interesting, and that is The Amazing Spider-Man, The Sins of Norman Osborn, and from the only issue of anything more recent Spider-Man-wise that I've read, this is a pretty good book. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about it. It's a pretty good read. It actually has a really exciting cliffhanger, I guess you could call it. I don't know, but it's really intense, and I really enjoyed it. And I also picked up Iron Man 2020 issue number 6, and this is the final issue of Iron Man 2020, I believe. So I haven't read issue 4 and up, so now that I have issue number 6, I'll definitely read it. And going back to Iron Man has a new series, and this is issue number 1, and I really, really love the cover. Like, it's a full wraparound cover, too, and it's just phenomenal looking. I really love the artwork by Alex Ross. I believe that's who it is. I mean, if it's not Alex Ross, then I don't know who else could do that, but it's an amazing cover. And then I have Silver Surfer number 1. This was just a random pickup because I really thought the cover was just cool looking. Like, there's a lot of, like, Easter eggs about other Marvel characters in there. Like Iron Man's helmet, Green Goblin's pumpkin bomb. And right up there is something from Spider-Man. I think that's a glove, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, pretty cool cover. And then this one, I have been really wanting to read more Deadpool, so I thought I'd get into the new Deadpool series, and this is issue number 1 of Deadpool King of the Monsters, I believe. I don't know if that's, like, the full story, like, title, but it's the newest Deadpool series that's come out. And then a series that I'm kind of sad is kind of canceled is West Coast Avengers, and they only made this a 10 issue run, I believe. I could be mistaken about that. I know I have issues 1 through 6, and I know I can get 8, 9, and 10, like, at least easy. And sorry if my camera is kind of a little blurry. I'm on a new phone, so it might be kind of focusing on something kind of weird. Apologize for that. And I picked this one up because I really enjoyed how the cover looked, and that is Thor. And this is, like, after he lost his arm, I know this is Thor that is in the newest Avengers run, which is on issue, like, 40, I believe, at this point. Could be wrong about that, but yeah, and I've also been kind of really getting into Thor lately, too. And then this pile, I have Maestro number 2, and I really cannot say anything more about how much I love the new Maestro series. I really, really enjoy it, and it's really amazing, and I really do recommend it. It's really good so far. And I don't know if I've shown this one off, but I have Marvel Zombies Resurrection number 1. And issue 2. And then issue 3. And, like, for issue number 4, I am very excited, but at the end of issue number 1, or issue number 1, at the end of at the end of issue number 3, there was a really, really big surprise that kind of blew my mind away. So, yeah. And I'm going to be taking a tiny little break from comic books and just showing you guys the figures that I have picked up too. Excluding, like, the DC figures that I've shown in their own separate video. So, starting off, I'm going to show you guys the Avengers Endgame 2-pack of Hawkeye and Black Widow, and I found this at Target, like, someone hid it under the shelf, and I found it, and I was pretty happy about it. So, always check underneath the shelves. And these two I actually picked up two or three months ago at this point, I want to say. And that was the Kraven and Spider-Man 2-pack. And I know I already have a Black Suit Spider-Man and a Kraven, but my Kraven has, like, a weird arm where it's, like, not tight at all. So it's just, like, very loose and can't stand up by itself sometimes. So I thought getting an upgraded Kraven would be nice. And also a newer Black Suit Spider-Man, just in case my other one breaks. And I also really like the head sculpt on it. So. And then from the vintage wave of the like Spider-Man figures, I picked up Electro and Peter Parker first, and those were pretty cool. And then I found the Spider-Man, and I actually really love the Spider-Man. Like, only thing wrong with the or mine anyway, is like one of his hands just keeps popping out really, really easy. So, but I fixed that. And then the final one I picked up from the vintage wave was the Green Goblin. And I mostly picked it up for the head, but I also really did think the glider was actually pretty cool looking. It's not much different from the older one rather than color, but I really liked the newer one more, so that's mainly why I picked him up. And I ordered this figure off of Amazon, and that would be the Superior Octopus, and his tentacles are actually up on that shelf right there, because I'm making a new display for, like, Spider-Man, so that's why I've kind of been buying a lot of Spider-Man figures lately. And this one I was really happy about, and that was the Cable figure. And just because I'm showing X-Men, I'll show the new Wolverine. Wolverine's actually the one of the latest pickups I've found. I found both of these at Walmart, actually. But I really love the Wolverine one. Like, it's pretty cool. It's not the ideal Wolverine that I want. Like, I want the one that's also just the, what's it called, wife beater. I want that one, too, because that one is how I always think of Wolverine. And then, for those of you who follow me on Instagram, I found the brand new Venom. And this guy is pretty beefy. The only thing wrong with him is, like, his feet are just, like, really tight, and he has kind of a hard time standing up, and I've tried heating them up, but they're not doing anything. I mean, they can twist, it's just that they can't move backwards or forwards when I try doing it, and I'm kind of worried about breaking him. So, yeah, but pretty awesome figure. And the final Marvel figure I picked up, I was very happy about this. Like, I was going to Walmart shopping for groceries and stuff, and I thought I'd stop by the figure aisle, and I found Warpath. And this was actually one of the main ones I wanted from the new Deadpool wave, aside from Sheikla and what's his face, Black Tom Cassidy. And I'm gonna wait on Black Tom because it seems like no one really, really wants him. Like, I want the entire Build-A-Figure wave, mainly because Strong Guy looks really cool. So yeah, that's basically all the Marvel related objects I've picked up. So starting with the DC, I have Heroes in Crisis issue number 1, and there's actually a lot of hate going around like this story. I actually really enjoyed it. I didn't think it was a terrible story at all. I actually really, really liked it. And could it have been better? Yes, but I really enjoyed it for what it was. And next up, I have the Batman 3 Jokers, and this is issue number 1. And they all come with a playing card, which I'm not going to take out of that one. But in issue number 2, it has a playing card like this that you just get separately. And I believe I have that right here, and this is how the second one looks. It has Batgirl and the I think it was the Joker who like shot her in the spine, if I'm not mistaken. I could be mistaken about that, but the first one was Batman and the different Joker. But I mean, this is a fantastic story so far, and I really, really can't wait to read issue number 3. Again, sorry about allergies. And then next up, I have DC's Dead Planet number 3. And this story is just a roller coaster at this point. It's like, I love it so much. It's so, so, so amazing. And this one's another one that recently came out, and that is issue number 4 of Deceased. And this one has a really, really big surprise in it, and I don't want to spoil it, but I really can't recommend it anymore. Like, Deceased is definitely one of the best things that, I almost said Marvel, that DC has made in a long time, in my opinion. Excuse me. And this one is issue number 1 of Batman, the Joker Warzone. And I think this is kind of like a one-off story for, like, what was it called? Like, Batman Joker War, which also recently ended, if I remember correctly. And then next one up is issue number 100 of the Batman story. And this is the final issue of the Joker War. So pretty excited about that. And I really, really liked the cover on this. Focus. Like, that is a beautiful, beautiful wraparound cover. And this is also kind of like a mini trade paperback, how I'm thinking of it. Because it is a really, really thicker type styled book. And this one, which is something that I picked up recently, is DC, The Doomed and Damned. It's like their yearly, what's it called? Halloween special? Or every other year, something like that. It's a Halloween special, and it has like about 5 stories in here. And so far, from what I've read, it's pretty good. And now time for my another series I am in love with, and that is DC Death Metal. And Death Metal is definitely one of the best things I've read in a while. And first off, we have Trinity Crisis. And for those of you who don't know what is happening in the Death Metal story, there's like a like, the best way I can explain it is like the entire multiverse is ending, and they're doing kind of like what they did for Marvel's 2015 Secret Wars, where they just shoved like multiple different planets onto one. And that's kind of what that is. That's kind of how I've understood how that is, because there's multiple different versions of characters. Like, if I remember correctly, it's kind of like this, which is another issue kind of segueing into this, and that is Multiverse's End. And this basically brings like multiple characters from multiple different realities into it. Like, there's Nazi Superman versus Guy Gardner and Captain Carrot of the Zoo Crew just fighting. And there's also a futuristic Flash from a planet that I'm not fully positive about. But so far, Death Metal is definitely a fantastic thing, and I love it. And then this one is Speed Metal, which is basically all about the Flashes and stuff like that, especially Wally West. Excuse me. Yeah, the Wally West version of the Flash. This is mostly a story kind of about him, and if you read Flash Forward, this kind of explains why he is blue and has Dr. Manhattan's little circle on his forehead. And yeah, like, if you read like just like, I personally recommend like reading the actual Death Metal storyline, and then like the Year of the Villain, I think it was called, like from Death Metal to the Year of the Villain to what's it called? Like the story that I showed first, Heroes in Crisis. And then Flash Forward, you could understand this at least partially well. Or at least that's kind of how I understood it, like why Wally West was in prison at the beginning of Flash Forward, blah 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 blah. Like, if you want to get in depth like I kinda did. And then the final issue is Death Metal, number 4. And I haven't read this yet, but I will definitely be reading it after this. And my God, do I love this story so far. I really, really do regret never picking up anything of, like, the actual Death Metal story. Or DC's Metal, or whatever it was called. Yeah, but this is a fantastic story, and I cannot recommend it any more than I do. And I've said that about a lot, but I really do mean it about this and the Maestro series. Like, Maestro is only going to be a... It's either going to be a 5-issue or 6-issue series, I believe. I'm pretty sure it's 5, but it could be 6. Not fully positive. But Maestro and Death Metal, definitely recommend you guys picking those up. But anyway, with that being said, that is the end of the video. So I really do appreciate you guys watching this video for as long as you have. And yeah, I really do appreciate it. So thank you all for watching. And with that being said, my name is Carnage, and I will catch all of you people in the next video.